our new videos. Let's go. In the first stage of design, when we don't have a big budget or we don't have any information about our site, or it is a school project, but still we need some necessary information and primary analysis, and sometimes we need this for our presentation. So we should model and simulate our site in this situation too. In this video, we want to help you to be familiar with the workflow of using existing information in several databases to obtain different types of data like topography, contour maps, buildings, roads, etc. For this video, we will use a platform called CADMapper. We will explain the workflow of this tool and Revit in this video. So let's go. Let's go to their website. I will put the link in the comment section too, or you can Google it. As they have mentioned here, you can download the files up to 1 square kilometer for free. But if you need bigger areas or a city, you should purchase an account for yourself. But it will be okay for most of our projects, so don't worry. And remember, for having access to download files, you need to create a free account in this website. Click on this area. This is the simple user interface of our work area. You have to know that the detail and accuracy of exported files depend on the city and country that you select. The only thing that may not work is building heights in some areas, but you can set the default elevation for them too. For example, when you set this parameter on 3 for all of the buildings which don't have any information about their heights, the platform will give them 3 meter high for default. Let's search for New York City, type New York here and press enter. Now we can select our building site here, but don't forget to choose areas with less than 1 square kilometer areas. I want to find a dense region to show you the power of this tool. So let's find a dense region here. Okay, this place will work for our goal. Zoom in a little bit, move it around. Okay, let's think that we want to design our building here. Now we should configure our export city. CADMapper can provide us with 6 different formats for exporting. For our goal, AutoCAD format is the best one because we can do some optimization in the file before importing that in Revit, and they have a better interpretation with each other. As we all know, the vendors of both of them are same, so it is a good reason to do that in AutoCAD. You can specify which items should exist in your file: buildings, topography, contour, and also you can specify the width of the roads here. Remember that if you want to make topography in Revit according to this information, you need contours, so don't forget to check this box. It is really necessary to create original Revit topographies. Put this option on the outline. It will help you in Revit to use subregion to create roads and parks. Okay, we're done here. Click on create file. Now you should wait for processing, and you can see a preview here too. Okay, our file is ready. Click on download button and download the file. Okay, we're done here. I will put the link in the comment section. In this stage, you should extract the zip file. This .txt file is our exported file. Let's open our AutoCAD. I should mention this again, these files are not as accurate as 3D scans or server contours, but they can be used for the first stage and primary analysis. Open the .txt file in AutoCAD. This is the site we have. It contains different layers like contours, topography, and etc. Usually, we don't need topography layer. We create our site with contours in Revit. This is our final file, but there is two work that we can use for file optimization. The first one is purge unused, and the second one is delete duplicate and overlap objects. When you finish the optimization, now save the file as a DWG file. When we compare the original file versus optimized file, we can see the difference in file sizes. But it is not just about the file size. These kinds of data work and process better in Revit after some optimization we made. Let's go to Revit and create a new file, okay? Type UN and change your unit to meter. To bring the file in, we have two ways, import CAD or lean CAD. For this video, I will use import CAD because we want to have more freedom to work with the file in this case. Go to the insert tab and click on import CAD. Put the file format on DWG from here. Select the file and remember to put the unit on the meter. It takes time a little bit. It depends on the file size and the complexity of your site. Okay, this is the file we need. The first thing I need is to change the color of the buildings. To do that, you need to go to the Manage tab, click on Object Style, and in Imported Object tab, change the material of building layer. The color of our buildings changed, that's nice. For the next step, I want to create my base topography. To create that, we need contours. Before starting, delete the topography layer. To do that, select one of the elements in the layer, then click on Query, and then remove the layer from here. Now, to continue, you should go to the Masking and Size tab, then click on Topo Surface from here. Click on Create from Import. In this stage, Revit asks us which layer is your contour. So select the contour layer only and click OK. Our topography is here. It is not perfect sometimes. Let's move some points to fix this. You can change the material of topography in properties. I want to switch it to another material. To create roads or specifying another material for a specific area, you can use split surface or subregion. But before that, let's put this topography in a section box to see the thickness of our site for a better presentation. Okay, let me show you the workflow of creating roads or changing the material for a specific area. One of the first things I always do is specifying the location of the project with building path tool. To do that, click here and then pick these lines with a small offset to specify your building location. It can be a start point for your primary modeling. Okay, let's create a simple road here. I'm not going to do this for all of the streets. I will just show you the workflow. Thank you. When you are done with your site, then you can start your primary modeling on the building.